Good morning. So I left this last night saying that I would possibly come back and put some ink on it this morning. And actually, the ink is in the studio, but I found these acrylic pens. And so I'm just using them. Because I'm only doing a very swift one. It's funny, you know, I thought I could let myself not do my yoga meditation paint this morning, that routine, but actually I didn't want to not do it, so here I am. And it doesn't feel like it's a whip cracking thing, you know, I'm forcing myself, but I do see the value in showing up for myself rather than against myself. Sometimes it can be showing up because I'm telling myself that I have to, and it comes from a place of fear. So I think it's in discerning what it is. Is it a desire to keep my ritual going, or is it fear that if I stop, something bad will happen? You know, one of those kind of superstitious thoughts. And I think, I feel this morning that, as soon as I start using colour anyway, that question goes, because it's always a soothing thing. So this tree, I became a bit obsessed last night and I ended up staying up for a very long, hours and hours. But I'm feeling quite good this morning now. So there, I'm going off. Okay. I had the thought to get some fluorescent pink like that, you know, and to really heighten some of the dark areas. I can do that later. I'm talking about the fluorescent pink acrylic ink, for example. With the droppers that I can drop on, like leaving them as baubles on top of the surface of this, and so that they stand out even more than the pinks here do. But this acrylic pen though is good, isn't it? It seems to be having an impact too. I didn't expect them to still be so fluid actually. I thought I'd have to be hammering against the page with them. This Dorzu acrylic painter. And I had the intention again of doing this in a 5 minute job, because I want to head off and teaching this morning. I want to go to the coffee shop first. I was going to do a bit of writing, artist's way style maybe, or just some sort of, just have a little bit of space at the start of the day to myself. I think it's quite nice. But I could sit here and have space here. I actually feel like I want to be somewhere where there isn't the option to do things. Where it's only, like I can focus, I think, when I go to a cafe, because that's all that I'm able to do. I can't be getting up and doing the dishes or that kind of carry on, you know? No. It's actually white here as well, I don't know if that works at all. A little bit. This might be the kind of one, yeah, that'll come out in a big blob suddenly. I think I can just let it alone though, and maybe by the time it dries, maybe when it dries it'll keep its shape, and so it'll be quite bright there still. Either that or it'll sink into the page. I think both would be fine. It's like little baubles of white are coming out. Yeah, I'm hoping that the ink will be a waterproof surface for these baubles to land on, and that then they'll stay as bright as they are now. Well, sometimes you wake up with a song in your head. This morning I woke up with a song, with "Can You Feel the Love Tonight?" But I thought it was "Can You Feel the Air Tonight?" And I was looking it up and it came up with Phil Collins. And he started saying, "I can feel it coming in the air tonight." I was like, oh no, quickly turn it off before I lost my own song. And then I remembered it was love. Can you feel the love tonight? That one. So I've just listened to Elton John. That was quite a nice beginning to my day. I was listening to David Hoyt last night as well, and he's got a new YouTube channel actually, which you can subscribe to, David Hoyt the poet and author, maybe, I don't know how he might call himself, kind of slightly philosopher too, possibly. Anyway, he had a really good poem about plans, which might be why I also kind of considered, oh, I never put on the microphone. Anyway, his poem about plans might have got me thinking about my thoughts on waking, and he said something like, there's a door open still on waking that shuts as soon as you plan your day, or something. I mean, his way of saying it was far more poetic than that now. There's another thing there that I wrote down that he spoke as well, another poem. I forget what it was called now. Something, he wrote it when he was going, when he was on an airplane. And something similar to what he was saying had come into my heart or something. You know, I had been thinking already about how we come as our particular shape into the world with our own little bumps and hollows and kind of cracks. And then the modelling of the world kind of works with our particular foibles, our particular shape, and creates. I was really feeling more than the world, that there's a kind of a creator that works with us, that is almost like in us, that we corroborate with in our lives somehow, without thinking though. But it's like you just show up as you are, and your nature, the creator, the world, somehow really efficiently uses every single element of who we are to ultimately create beauty, I believe. Something like that anyway. And so his poem was "Working Together." We shape ourselves to fit this world, and by the world are shaped again. I like that. I mean, it's not exactly what I was thinking of, but it's along the lines, you know, like when you have thoughts and feelings that are somehow I don't know what the word is, affirmed maybe by things in the environment, and this poem feels like an affirmation. The visible and the invisible working together to create the miraculous. And then later on he says, so may we in this life trust to those elements we have yet to see or imagine, and find the true shape of our own selves by forming it well to the great intangibles about us. There you are now, a bit of poetry for the morning. This is a little bit compelling. Joining these dots, placing these dots down on my tree. And I'm still in my pajamas. I want to get myself up and out so that I've got time to get petrol, go to the cafe, and have an easy meander along to my teaching job. It's about a 40-minute drive. Oh, hitting my head off the thing now. Never sure how much is going to come out. Let's see. Okay, that is quite purple, isn't it? Excuse me. Not sure if it's loaded with ink, but it's dark. Big one. Oh, even bigger. I guess when it's dry I can make a little bit more sense of it again if I need to. I've got the sense of getting trigger happy. It's a thin line, isn't it? Where you kind of let yourself meander through it and keep going. Or where you kind of have this compulsion about you wanting to keep going in a kind of a desperate attempt to fend something off, maybe. Ooh. That felt a bit edgy. You probably can't hear me anyway. Let's put a few splashes in the roots there. And there we have it. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Leave that open and hopefully midnight won't walk on it. And have a lovely day. Nice to see you, and I'll catch you tomorrow. Tomorrow's a busy day. Maybe I could set myself up to say tomorrow's going to be, as my therapist used to say, there's plenty of time, plenty of things to do. That's the kind of day I'm going to have tomorrow. Plenty of time, plenty of things to do. Setting up the gallery is what we're doing tomorrow, you know, the one in Roslyn. So come along and see us from Thursday to Sunday, from 10 until 4. I'll have paintings and drawings and prints and cushions, coasters, what else? Little tote bags, actually, with prints of sunflowers and other flowers and a portrait of Lake. Three different designs. And cards, lots of cards. Okay. Speaking of lots of love. See you tomorrow. Bye.